Yeah, huh? happy Uranos locked all the Cyclopes away with the other Titans, huh?
Yes. He was afraid they'd overthrow him. There was a prophecy.
Bored. Grandpappy made the right call. Those things are an eyesore. Get it?
The birth of Aphrodite is a gruesome tale.
Nothing gruesome about it. Grandpappy Uranos and my deadbeat dad, Kronos, had a battle so great it severed heaven from earth.
That's not all that was severed. During his surprise attack, Kronos descended on Uranos.
When earth was severed from heaven, there was a great earthquake that knocked a pearl loose from its oyster.
Hang on, there was no...
The pearl flew from its oyster on land, and Uranos caught it and flung it out to sea with such a force that it caused the frothy foam to bubble. from the sea foam. Aphrodite rose, full grown, beautiful as that same pearl.
I can't take this anymore. Zeus, Gaia lied to you about how Aphrodite was born.
Oh yeah? Then tell me how it really happened.
To Kronos. They fought.
You can't be serious.
Fell into the sea.
That's...
because Kronos cut off his...
You're sick, Prometheus! Do not talk to me!
With the sea foam secure...
Ah...
Phoenix resolved to return to Aphrodite with the key to her freedom and the vault. Muse, tell me the deeds of golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song. Stir up my sweetest passions.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
You've returned, you sweet creature. Do you have the sea foam?
Right here.
Oh, aren't you good? Please, take my blessing for all your hard work. Now quick, pour the foam on my roots. The sooner I can move, the sooner I can expand my apple care.
Did it work?
Coming out of the foam, I was so... fabulous. No! There's too many godly creatures that need my help. It keeps me awake at night, just seeing their little beaks and bright eyes. And those noses. Those quivering, wet noses.
Ha!
just happened?
Typhon must not like you. Though I couldn't possibly imagine why. Whenever anyone defies him, he sends one of his raids. And that raid delegates responsibility, as raids tend to do, to Shades.
So the warrior that just appeared wasn't really Achilles?
Goodness, no! The true Achilles is far more dashing.
Oh, you're telling me.
He's hiding in a lair nearby. Until he's defeated, his Shades will reappear on this part of the island.
Is there ever any good news?
Well, the sea foam worked and... I'm able to move my roots. One of them was actually blocking Achilles' lair. I can't help but the other three raids, though. Heracles, Atalanta, and Odysseus. Oh, you know what they say. Bad things come in fours.
No one says that.
No one says that.
Tough crowd.
What about the root blocking your essence? It's just that some people I care about have been turned into stone. So I'm quite keen to...
Nope. For some reason, that root is still firmly in place. Thank you for your concern. But what matters is I can start delivering apples. All the animals will be fed in no time. Pescatuit, thank you kindly for all your help. Many happy returns.
But I... That was strange.
I can't keep standing idly by. Sorry, I mean busily preparing anymore. You have to bring Aphrodite back to her beautiful, snarky self before I go crazy!
By the gods, where did you come from?
Behind you? Doesn't matter. Don't worry about me. Focus on finding another way to shrivel that root.
So what? Saltier, more mythical water? Actually, wait. What about Aphrodite's tears? Didn't she cry at the death of Adonis? They'd be salty and powerful.
You really know your stories, kid. Her tears just might work, if you put them directly on the root, blocking off her essence. Now, where did Typhon hide them? You should search the vaults of Tartarus nearby. There are three crystallized tears.
All right, we have a plan then.
Please hurry. Until Aphrodite is back to herself, who will I talk to about whatever this is that you're wearing?
What's wrong with what I'm wearing? And he's gone.
Let me know if you're in the market for anything. I'm here selling. You're buying. Huh!
Typhon had cruelly left the tears Aphrodite cried for her lost love in the very place Adonis was locked away from her.
That poor go-go boy, boo-hoo, please. I was just down in the underworld with Hades for nearly a month. And let me tell you, it slayed.
So that's where you were during the Typhon attack.
I had to sample the new Lethean wine vintage. You know how it is. I kept forgetting to leave.
No tear weighs so heavily as a tear of love, and so no tear had ever been as heavy as this. The tear from the broken heart of the goddess of love.
Bah! Like Aphrodite is the first person to ever go through a breakup.
Zeus, it wasn't a breakup. He died.
True.
Phoenix could have sworn the tears Aphrodite shed in grief for Adonis somehow weighed heavier when brought out of the underworld. Huh.
Huh.